Let's bring in some text. I'm going to go to the type tool and I'm going to click and drag a type frame out, and it'll fill with this nonsense text. It's called lorem ipsum text after the first two words, which are just, it's kind of like Latin nonsense. And we're going to go to the type menu, go to area type options. Let's make the number of columns 2. And why don't we, let's just leave as is. I can preview this also. And that looks pretty good to me. Okay, now we need some actual text. So I'm going to go back to my project folder, and I'm going to open the Word document. All right, and I'm just going to select all the text, copy it, go back to Illustrator, text frame, Command A to select all our new text inside. Now, before we start formatting this, we want to take a look at a few things here. So, go ahead and zoom in. So, first of all, we can take the specialty pizza, and we can actually, let's copy that to our new text frame for now. And we'll get rid of some of the spacing. And what we want is, we want to have the name of the pizza above. The way that this came in, it's not quite like that. So we can actually just go ahead and delete some of this. It's called baked potato pizza. I'm gonna delete that down there. Paste it up on top. Next, let's just get rid of some of this extra stuff. Let's see, right here. So let's get rid of this, return, and pasting that in. And I'm going to simplify this a little bit further, so because the way I want to do it is I want to make the size, and I'm going to change the prices to be a little bit more realistic, or etc. And I'm going to leave the sizes the same. So the one thing that I notice here is that we need to check this text that we're getting. Let's assume that we're getting this text formatted correctly. So for example, these little inch mark there, quotation marks, and inch marks are straight up and down. So we need to replace all of these little quotation marks with the correct inch marks. So there's a pretty easy way to do this. I'm going to go ahead and copy one of these, so Command C. So I'm going to the Edit menu, choose Find and Replace. And what we want, Command V, that quotation mark, double quotation mark, into the Find with an inch mark. All right, I'm going to replace that with an actual inch mark. So I'm going to go to the character, and I need to click in the replace with window, and then I can correct one. It's a straight up and down inch mark, and double click, and there it is. All right, I'm going to choose find, and then let's do replace all. Our double quotation marks with inch marks. All right, so I want to choose a font and size. Select all. Let's bring out our character window. You can get some of these options up here, but I like to have the camera. It's real convenient. So I'm going to look for Minion. We're going to use Minion. let's make the leading 13.5. And I'm tracking up to a negative 3 just to tighten it up a little bit. All right, format. So I'm going to choose Avenir for this. Now, if you don't have these, find something similar. Let's do bold. The tracking, even more on that. Oops. Negative 25. And then we'll make it 14 points. And I'm going to change the color. So this one. Okay, next we're going to format the price information. So again, I'm going to choose Avenir. Hold. Let's do and make the leading 12 point. Let's paragraph space before and after. So let's see what we want to do. So right now, there's a whole space at the bottom of our pricing information and the next item. And I want to get rid of that space. And I want to use the paragraph after. So let's try 6 on that. Let's try tight. Okay, 12 might work. Let's try a little bit to 4. About 2. How about 4? That's pretty good. For our header, we can do something similar. So, let's go ahead and do a little space app, make some adjustments later.